Hello folks, here is Professor Francisco Gomes. If you really want to know what happens to your body when you are fasting, you should watch this video. Recently, that's what I did. I measured my blood, ketone, and glucose level during a 24-hour fasting. So, let's get to the video. I'm starting my fasting today, and I'm going to measure my blood level and also my ketone level. So I'm using those strips for the glucose and this one for the ketone. Okay, now I'm going to poke my finger. So it read ketone. Now I'm going to take the glucose. Now the countdown. (4.9 mmol/L). Okay, that's it. So now I'm going to lunch, and in 1 hour I'm going to repeat this, in 2 hours, in 4 hours, in 8 hours, and tomorrow until I finish my fasting. And then we'll see, in the name of science, I'll be poking all my fingers. Now I'm going to lunch in 1 hour time. And after 1 hour I have eaten this, I'm going to measure again my glucose level. So I'm going to measure again my blood glucose. Let's now poke the end of the finger. (5.3 mmol/dL). So 1 hour ago it was 4.9 when I had lunch, before I had lunch. 1 hour after, now it's 5.3. Okay, now it's 2 hours after, 2 hours after the lunch, and I'm going to take blood from my big finger. Let's see, big drop of blood, 6.3. So it means that digestion is still going on, and right now the food should be in the intestine. It was in the stomach for a while. As you saw, I ate a balanced diet, not full of, not too much sugar. There was meat, there was protein, there was fat, lots of olive oil, and then that kept the food inside my stomach for a while. And now the blood glucose is still going up, and the insulin has not yet taken the blood glucose to the level there was prior to the lunch. So let's see now, I did 2 hours, now in 4 hours, I'm going to measure again. 17:32, 5:30 p.m. It's been approximately 4 hours that I have been fasting. And then I'm going to poke my index finger and see my glucose level. Let's go. Okay, 4.6 mmol/L. That is below the level that I was before my lunch. So it means that insulin went up and then took the glucose and shuttled inside the cells. So from now on, my glucose level should go down. It's lower than it was before. And then let's see at what level it will stabilize. So the next one is going to be 8 hours into fasting, and it's going to be my thumb-like finger. Now it's 9:30 p.m. and I've been fasting for 8 hours. So let's see. Let's see the glucose. 4.1. So have you seen my glucose went down on the last time? It's 4.1. That's the 8 hours fasting. Thumbs up. And tomorrow morning I'm going to measure my glucose and also my ketone. Bye. See you tomorrow. Hello. Now it's 7:30. The other day, I'm 18 hours into my fasting, and I'm going to measure my blood glucose and also my ketone. So let's do it. Four millimoles. Yesterday was 4.1. Went down. Now let's check the ketone. You can see ket 0.3. So it increased by 50%. Now I'm going to measure at 1:30 p.m. It's going to be 24 hours into my fasting. Hi, now it's 1:30. I've been fasting for 24 hours. I ate just a few nuts, maybe 50 calories maximum. And I'm going to measure my glucose and then my ketone. So let's start with the glucose. It went up. Why did it go up if I'm fasting? Should have gone down. Okay, now let's see the ketone. The countdown is 10 seconds. 0.4. Interesting. Okay, I'm going now to have my lunch after 24 hours fasting. I'm going to eat. That's the end of part one of this video. At part two, we'll analyze the importance of this data. So why is it important to have your glucose level low? And most importantly, why is very interesting for your health, for your brain health, for your metabolic health, to have an increase in the ketone body level? Stay tuned and subscribe to my channel.